असतो मा सद्गमय, तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय, मृत्यो मा अमृतं गमय।
Now we are going to learn the spherical mirrors, that is concave mirrors or convex mirrors forms images. But before going to learn about that, first of all we have to learn the important key terms about concave mirror and convex mirror. We know the spherical mirror is a part of sphere. So the spherical mirror, which is polished inside and coated outside, is known as concave mirror. And the spherical mirror, which is polished outside and coated inside, is known as convex mirror. So here I want to draw, right? So the mirror which is polished inside and coated outside is known as concave mirror. And the mirror which is polished outside and coated inside, this is known as convex mirror. And a spherical mirror is assumed to be a part of sphere, right? So here this spherical mirror is assumed to be a part of sphere. So here this is having a center, that is known as center of curvature, and it is represented by capital C, right? And it is also having one of the center, that is P, that nothing but pole, right? This is also having the center, that is pole. It is represented with capital P, right? An imaginary line is passing through center of curvature, and pole of the mirror is known as principal axis. So this is a principal axis. So when an imaginary line is passing through center of curvature, and pole of the mirror is known as principal axis, right? So here the light falling on the mirror is represented as incident ray. So this is the incident ray. The light falling on the mirror is incident ray, right? The ray reflected from the spherical mirror is known as reflected ray. So this is the reflected ray. So here I want to write reflected ray. And the line perpendicular to the surface of the mirror at point of incidence is known as normal. So this is a point of incidence, right? So from this, the line is perpendicular to the surface of the mirror, right? So this is known as normal. Here also, and remember that the normal ray is always passes through the center of curvature. Okay, it is always passes through the center of curvature only, right? So here the angle between incident ray and normal is known as angle of incidence, and it is represented by angle I. Okay, it is represented by angle I. And here also, this is the angle I. And here, the angle between normal and reflected ray is known as angle of reflection. So it is denoted by angle R. Okay, so here I want to write the terms. So C is nothing but center of curvature, right? And P is a pole, and angle I is a angle of incidence, and angle R is a angle of reflection. Right? So there is no space to write us some more key terms here, so I want to rub this. So we know this is the concave mirror. So how can we identify this is a concave mirror? Means which is coated outside, right? Now this is coated inside. So this is a convex mirror, right? Now we know that it is having the center C, and one more, it is pole. And here also I want to take, and we know the imaginary line is passing through between center of curvature and pole of the mirror. So this is the principal axis. Now here, when the rays are parallel to the principal axis on the concave mirror and convex mirror, when the rays are parallel to the principal axis, after reflection it passes through one common point, right? After reflection the passes through one common point on the principal axis. Right, here also. So this is known as principal focus, and it is denoted by capital F. So one more time I want to tell you, the rays which are parallel to the principal axis, after reflection they passes through one common point on the principal axis, is known as principal focus. And the principal focus is denoted by capital F. Okay, now here we have center of curvature, principal focus and pole on both concave and convex mirrors. So here the distance between pole and center of curvature is known as radius of curvature. Okay, so the distance between center of curvature and pole, this is known as radius of curvature, and it is denoted by capital R. Okay, remember that the distance between pole and center of curvature is known as radius of curvature, and it is denoted by capital R. And here the distance between pole and principal focus, the distance between pole and principal focus of the mirror is known as focal length of the mirror. Okay, that is denoted by small f. Here also, the distance between these two is the small f. So the distance between pole and principal focus of the mirror is known as focal length of the mirror. It is denoted by small f, right? So here the principal focus is the midway of pole and center of curvature, right? So here the principal focus is midway of pole and center of curvature, which suggests that the focal length is half of the radius of curvature, right? The focal length is half of the radius of curvature. Okay, so here I want to write the terms. So here I will write. So one by one I want to write. So here the new terms in this diagram, F, capital F is the focal length, principal focus. And small f is the focal length. And r is the radius of curvature. Okay. Now I want to tell you some more terms. So I want to rub this diagram. So, you know, this is a concave mirror. And this is a convex mirror. Right? So, here we have a center of curvature and pole. Right, so one imaginary line, nothing but principal axis, right? So here I want to tell the distance from the pole at which the object is placed is known as object distance. The distance from the pole and at which the object is placed is known as object distance. It is denoted by small u. Okay, sorry, I forgot it here. We have principal focus here between pole and the center of curvature. So remember that the distance from the pole at which the object is placed is known as object distance. It is denoted by small u. Okay, and here also right, see here, and the distance at which between the pole and the image is formed is known as image distance. So for example, the image is formed here means, so we are calling this as a image distance. So the distance at which between the pole and the image distance is known as image distance. So where the image is formed from the distance of the pole, that is known as image distance. So this is denoted by small v. Okay, now see here, if the image is formed on the screen is known as real image. If the image is formed on the screen is known as real image. And if the image only can be screened in the mirror is known as virtual image. So this is a virtual image. And now if the object and the image are in same direction, Okay, if the object and the image formed by the here, those are in same direction, means right way up, those are known as erect images. So here in the convex mirror, the two images are object and the image formed by this two are in same direction. So here this is a erect image. Okay, and the object and image formed by the mirror both are in opposite direction, means one is up and one is down. That type of images are known as inverted images. So these are the inverted image. Okay, once I want to repeat here. So here the distance at which the object is formed from the pole, that is known as object distance here, that is denoted by small u, and the distance at which from the pole the image is formed, that is known as image distance, that is denoted by small v, same as is on the convex mirror also. And here the if the image is formed on the screen, that is known as real image. If the image only can be on the screen in the mirror, that is known as virtual image, right? If the object and image are in same direction, means right way up or right way down, so those are known as erect images. And if the image and object both are in opposite direction, means one is up and one is down, those are known as inverted image, right? So these are the keywords important for concave and convex mirror terminology, right?